Welcome back students, welcome to quarantine classes. So this is the first video I am making on whiteboard. So the topic we are discussing today is gametogenesis. So what do we mean by gametogenesis? Simply, it's the formation of gamete. Gamete means either sperm or egg. So, in other words, if you say gametogenesis is a process by which the germinal epithelium of the gonads undergo meiosis and forms the sperm or egg is known as gametogenesis, right? So, if we consider the gonads, that is, what are gonads? Gonads are either testes in case of male, and in case of female, it is ovary. So, as we have studied the internal structure of testes and ovary, we have found that they have the wall of the testes and ovary has a special kind of cell. Those cells are known as germinal epithelium. Remember, these are also termed as primordial germ cells. So, remember, these are special kind of cells, right? They are a kind of stem cell. Now, what do we mean by stem cell? The cells which have the capacity or potency to differentiate into other kind of cell. These are known as stem cells. So, the germinal epithelium of the testes or ovary is a kind of stem cells that will divide and finally form into sperm or egg. Right? So, gametogenesis can be divided into two separate categories. If it is the formation of male gamete, then it will be termed as spermatogenesis, and it will occur inside the testes. If you remember the structure of the testes, in fact the structure of seminiferous tubule, so here these are the germinal epithelium. If you remember, these are the germinal epithelium. In between the germinal epithelium, there will be some Sertoli cells that will provide nutrition to the sperm. So, this germinal epithelium will undergo what? These germinal epithelium cells will undergo meiosis and finally transform into sperm or the male gamete. Similarly, if we consider the wall of the ovary, so if it occurs inside the ovary, that is the formation of the process of formation of female gamete is known as oogenesis. Similarly, if you remember the structure of ovary, this is the graafian follicle. So there are also some germinal epithelium cells or primordial germ cell. These cells will give rise to the ovum. They will develop into firstly follicle, primary follicle, then there will be secondary follicle, then there will be tertiary, and finally it will develop into a functional ova. So this is the basic idea of gametogenesis, in which the germinal epithelium of either testes or ovary undergoes meiosis and produces the male and female gamete respectively. So this is the basic idea about gametogenesis, that it will occur inside the ovary and it will finally form the female gamete. So this is a brief idea just. In the next videos I will be discussing the spermatogenesis and oogenesis separately in detail. I hope you have understood the basic idea. So they are actually stem cells, that is they can transform into various kind of cell. These germinal epithelium can form sperms, and in case of ovary this germinal epithelium cell can form female gamete, that is ova. So this is the introduction. Thank you.